Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. I appreciate you clicking on that video as always. And we are back with another weekly wears episode. What I wore all 7 days last week, every fragrance for every day. If you're new to the channel, this is something we do once a week. Typically every Monday, I will drop a video discussing all the fragrances that I wore the week prior. It's a great way for me to sort of explore my collection and try different things as opposed to going to the same fragrances over and over. And at the end of the video, I always ask everyone to drop in the comment section below what you wore last week. If that's content that you think you would like, please be sure to subscribe to the channel. I appreciate the support, but without further ado, let's get into the list. So this first fragrance was a somewhat recent pickup for me. It was one that I had tried. I want to say I had tried it at a Sephora, and immediately I was like, I love this fragrance. At the time, there was just too many fragrances that I wanted, and I had a great opportunity to get this at a discount, although this particular house doesn't typically discount their fragrances. So I ended up grabbing this one. So scent I'm talking about is Chanel's Platinum Egoist. Man, what can I say about this stuff? It's so good. This is your typical, smelling in there right now. It's your typical barbershop fougere. It has lavender, geranium, and oak moss. But what this fragrance just sort of puts together for me is being in a barber seat, getting a fresh haircut, having the talcum powder put on the back of your neck, maybe a warm towel, and just feeling fresh and clean. This is an easy year-round wear. There is really no season that this doesn't work in. It's sort of a take on classic masculinity, and this is an early 90s release, but it holds true to some of its predecessors in terms of the aromatic fougères, and it just is simply amazing. It has really good longevity. This will last you a full work day. Really safe in any situation, whether it be going to the office or going out for dinner or going to a wedding or some type of event. This is going to work. It is a classic fragrance and it smells incredible. Chanel's Platinum Egoist. So if you don't already, be sure to follow me on Instagram, because if you did follow me on Instagram, you would know what my Monday's scent of the day was. Certain times during the week, I will share my scent of the day and give you an early look at what I wore. So on Monday, the scent that I went with is Moschino's Toy Boy. Fantastic atomizer on this. I feel like people don't talk about the atomizer, but incredible atomizer, a bit pressurized. And oh man, this stuff, I kind of get why it's a bit polarizing. It's different. It's different for a designer fragrance. Really unique and just smells fantastic. This is actually one of my wife's favorites. Every time I have this on, she gives me a compliment. She actually likes it for herself. I think it does walk the line of unisex. However, for a rose fragrance, it can be pulled off by a guy for sure. And I know some guys are afraid of rose or not crazy about rose, but I encourage you to give this one a try. Pink pepper, pear, nutmeg, adding a bit of spiciness in that rose is what I get. And I also get sort of a watery rose. I sort of imagine walking through a garden, maybe just after the sun comes up and there's water on the rose in the garden. It's just a bit of a watery rose and it's just a lovely scent and works fantastically, really in any situation. This is super versatile. I would say that Toy Boy has above average performance in terms of longevity and decent projection as well. So you're gonna smell this on you all day. I can even smell it the next day if you spray this on clothes. Great performance and usually can be found. This is the 50 ml for under $40 or around the $40 mark. I'll be sure to link it down below. Love this one, Moschino's Toy Boy. So on Tuesday, I went with a fragrance that has been heavily hyped and for good reason. It is a fantastic cheapie. It's one of the best cheapies, in my opinion, that you can get. And I wore it on Tuesday. Scent I'm talking about is Versace Blue Jeans. Not the best atomizer. It kind of just shoots it out, little short shots. I think it's important to note that this fragrance came out somewhere around the early to mid 90s, and it was massively popular in the early 2000s. So it had a 10-year stretch, but I think it really resonated with young people. This was a popular fragrance at the time, and people in their early 20s were wearing this to clubs and bars. You smelled this everywhere. It was a more modern example of the aromatic fougere. This, you smell this and it smells dated, but in a good way, and it's a bit different with this twist of vanilla that they throw in here, along with what is typically found in aromatic fougères. It has 1,000 notes, but what I mainly get is a bright citrus up top, a really clean lavender, a mix of florals, and of course that vanilla that I spoke about. This is not one that I wore at that time in the early 2000s when it was so popular, but this is one of those ones that if you walked into a Macy's, they would sort of shove down your throat and say, you need to smell this one, you need to buy it today. So I was wearing other things, but this, now I can appreciate it for what it is, which is a bridge between what an aromatic fougère was in the 80s, and it bridges it into the 90s, and you get that in Versace Blue Jeans. Really good performance, performs all day, kind of beast mode performance. You don't want to go heavy with this. You more than likely you will attract attention, but it might not be the most positive attention if you overspray. But really great scent nonetheless, and can usually be had for under $20. Yeah, if you're on a budget, this is kind of a no-brainer. Versace Blue Jeans. So on Wednesday, I had some appointments to go to, and I just wanted something fresh and inviting and not overpowering and just office safe. And the scent I went with is Givenchy's Gentleman EDT. I really love this scent. I think it's really underrated. The EDP gets all the love. It smells great in the air. The EDP gets all the love on this one. It's a lighter and brighter use of iris. So if you've smelled the eau de parfum concentration, there's leather, there's more resinous sort of aspects to that fragrance. This is a much more lighter, less dense iris, and it's used beautifully. Think almost a fresher Prada Loam, in my opinion. I actually prefer this over Prada Loam, and Prada Loam is considered to be one of the more sort of hyped office scents. If this isn't first, it comes in a close second if you're talking about iris-based fragrances. This has decent longevity. It will get you through a work day, and I actually smelled this the next day on my clothes, so this is a better performer than I think it gets credit for. It's just a really pleasant smell, and people will appreciate you if you're in the office and you're wearing something like this. I would imagine you're gonna be appreciated and not say, who's the cologne guy? Get him out of here. Wore it on Wednesday, Givenchy Gentleman EDT. So on Thursday, I wore another fragrance that is considered a cheapie. It can be usually found for under the $40 mark, or around there. And I got this one for a great deal. I found it at a Burlington, and I think they may have mislabeled it or mispriced it because it was around the $20 mark, $20, $25. And it's not one that I had owned up until then, but it's a super popular freshie. The scent I am talking about is Versace Man Eau Fraiche. This is a green, woody aromatic. This is a great daytime wear. Extremely inoffensive. It doesn't have the best longevity, but as I said, it's in that cheapy range, and you really will feel confident overspraying this. It's hard to overspray this. This has sort of a unique note of starfruit, which just adds a freshness, a bit of sweetness, some greenness, and just the slightest hint of this sour fruit. And it just works really beautifully, especially on hot days. This thing is a beast on hot days. It's gonna get you through a hot day, and it's just also gonna sort of make you feel a little bit fresher and cleaner. It has a slight aquaticness to it, but not as much as maybe the bottle would lead you to believe, although I do get some aquatics from this. It's more of a green, fresh, woody scent, and definitely woody in the dry down. So definitely worth a sniff. Great scent though, nonetheless, Versace Man Eau Fraiche. So on Friday, we were getting downpours in the New England area, and every time it rains, I find myself going for a vetiver fragrance or a vetiver-based fragrance, and this one is one of my favorites in my collection. Probably my favorite flanker of this line, really popular high-end designer line, and I got this for a fantastic price. The scent I am talking about is Terre d'Hermes Eau Intense Vetiver. So, oh man, in the air, just beautiful scent. I would say that this isn't a sort of blind buy safe fragrance, only because up top, and it doesn't last through the life of the fragrance. The vetiver sticks around, but it's not as in your face as in the opening of this. It's a very realistic, earthy, fruity, smoky, dark vetiver mixed with some citrus. And that's what I love about it. It's a bit of a darker take on the OG Terre d'Hermes. It's an interesting and sort of introspective type of fragrance. I can imagine like reading a book and wearing this on a rainy day and it being sort of really pleasant and enjoyable. This has pretty good performance. I personally wished that vetiver stuck around longer in the way you get it in the opening. It's at its heart a vetiver based fragrance, but I really enjoy the opening on this. And the first time I smelled this, I did not. I was maybe not ready for it. I smelled it and I said, whoa, that's like too dirty for me. It's too sort of earthy and reminded me of dirt. I've grown to love it. I've grown to appreciate it for what it is. And it's one of my favorite, as I said, vetiver based fragrances in my collection. Terre d'Hermes 010 Vetiver. So finally on Saturday, I was grabbing dinner with some friends. We got together. We haven't seen each other in a long time. And this particular group of friends, we don't get together often. Life, kids, family, all kind of sort of takes over. So we put it on the books and we said, we're going to get dinner. And I find myself that I've been wearing this fragrance quite a bit this past year for evenings out. And I think it's a fantastic, underrated evening out fragrance. I think everyone needs to get their nose on. And probably my favorite in the line scent I'm talking about is Jean-Paul Gaultier's Les Beaux EDT. Oh man, it's so good. So my friend, every time I wear this around my friends, someone will say, what are you wearing? I want that, what is it? And I tell them, and this, as I said, it's Le Male's Le Parfum gets a ton of hype, gets a ton of love. And for good reason, that scent is fantastic. Great scent for going out, really sort of buttoned up and put together, well-rounded fragrance. This is a little more fun. This is a little more sort of casual, but also can be worn out in a situation where you're at like a nice steakhouse and just hanging out with some friends. It has what I would say a more grown up sort of perspective on the quote unquote bubblegum fragrance, which I'm sure you've heard that expression used, bubblegum. And it, I wouldn't say it's bubblegummy. It has this beautiful pulpy, fruity, sweet coconut note. And it's one of the better coconut fragrances that I've smelled. Coconut can be sort of a touchy note to sort of use. And it can come across as suntan lotion, which I hate. I hate it when it smells like that. And I want nothing to do with it. And it also has this really nice vanillic sort of ambery dry down tonka bean. It's not overly complex, but super likable. I have not tried the Eau de Parfum or the EDP concentration. This is the EDT. And I don't know, I'm happy with this. I'd like to try the Eau de Parfum, but for me, projection wise, longevity, this sort of just checks all the boxes and I couldn't be happier with it. The other thing I like about this is that it really works in all seasons. So when you wear it in the summer, you think, wow, this is a great warm weather fragrance or a night out fragrance in the summer. And then when you wear it in cooler weather, you're like, wow, this is a great cooler weather night out evening fragrance. So And I also think you could wear it during the day too. I just, for me, I like to wear it at night. It's a decent performer. And as you can tell, I'm a fan of it. I've made a pretty good dent in this and I have many fragrances. So wore it on Saturday, Jean-Paul Gaultier's Les Beaux. That's all I have today, guys. As always, let me know in the comment section below what your weekly rotation was. What did you wear last week? I'd love to know. If you like what you saw today, please be sure to like, comment, subscribe, share this video, hit that bell notification so you're updated whenever I upload new content. But until then, have a fantastic week and I'll see you in the next video.